Welcome back, my dear viewers. Our main topic today, we're discussing the role of children's university in Egypt in developing the characteristics of new generations and its importance. Well, to shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to host today in this episode of Cairo Local Time, Dr. Gihan Hamza, the project manager in Children University at Heliopolis University. Welcome, Dr. Hamza. Well, Dr. Hamza, what is the idea of the Children's University?
The idea of the Children's University, the program itself of the Children's University has been implemented by the ASRT, the Egyptian Academy of Scientific Research and Technology. Yes. It has been implemented in 2015 in 27 universities all around Egypt. They now became 33 universities. Some of these universities are private universities, like our university. We are proud that we were working hand on hand with the academy to put the activities and the curriculum of Children's University.
Yes.
The program depends on hosting the universities, hosting some of the students from the schools, different schools, to the university to introduce for them the life in the university.
Or the model of the life and the model of
the university.
Being in a university.
To move from one lecture room to another, and to learn and to gain some knowledge in different fields like engineering, pharmacy, also Egyptology.
Yes.
The program for each student, three semesters, but in 3 years, one in summer, one in winter, and in spring.
Yes.
In the summer, we are working 2 weeks in a row.
Yes.
But in the winter and the spring, we are working on Saturdays.
Yes. So, what are the ages of the students that you receive in the Children's University?
It's starting from 9 years old until 15 years old.
So the stage of primary and also preparatory and the secondary school, of course.
Yes.
Well, Dr. Hamza, the sustainable development is one of the main targets of this project. Could you tell us more about it?
Simply, sustainable development is to trying to save the resources of the world or the gifts of our God, trying to work to save these resources for the coming generations.
Yes.
And education for sustainable development is the hands-on experience and the interactive learning process.
Yes.
In the Children's University or in our private university, we are dealing how to cope the materials and
yes.
activities with the pillars of sustainable development. For example, in Children's University, in pharmacy, they have to know that we can extract medicine from plants and from natural products. In engineering, they can construct a green city, how to construct this building by windows which can allow daylight all over the day to save electricity.
Yes.
They have to know from where can we get the renewable energy,
yeah.
from how we can filter the water, for example, to water the gardens. This is the faculty of environment. This is the pillar of environment,
yes.
Of sustainable development. As for the pillar of social pillar, the social pillar in humanities, they are dealing with the idea, for example, the idea of freedom. They learn it or not learn it, they can reach a conclusion that freedom is not an ultimate freedom. We have to respect other, the freedom of the others. Yeah. We have not to overlap our freedom with the others. They learned the human rights and how to respect and the regulations, yes, and the laws of the human rights. for example, for the cultural pillar, we invited the performance of Elila Kibira. Yeah. It is an Egyptian folklore, of course, and it was amazing because it's very interesting for the parents and for the students also. From that side, we are dealing in a very simple way by the sustainable development in our curriculum in the university, yeah, or in the children's university. Yes. And by the way, our second name of our university is For Sustainable Development.
For Sustainable Development. So what are the other fields that you are dealing with? What are the other fields?
Our university is specialized in a certain program. There are seven tracks in the children's university. All the universities has to deal with seven tracks. Six of them are obligatory from the academy. They have to deal with engineering, pharmacy, humanities. But the seventh one is optional for each university to deal.
Yes.
As our university, we are specialized in a program called the core program. The core program really touches the heart. The owner of our university, Dr. Ibrahim Abulayesh, rahmatullah alayh, led us to believe that when you are working on the spirit of the human being, you are building the human being. Yeah. So this program, the students, the university students and the children's university students, yeah, used to learn languages, history, music, acting, fine arts, and languages. So when you are built the human being spiritually, he can get the best performance in the other fields, scientific, yes, fields and engineering fields, like for example.
Yeah. So what are the latest achievements by the Children's University?
The last semester, the closing day or the closing ceremony in the last semester, we tried another way. Instead of let the students to make a presentation of two or three slides and stand, we decided to get a tangible product. What is a tangible product? That they are working on a model from day one to present it in an exhibition. And this exhibition divided into booths, yes, several booths, and they have to booths for humanities, booths for engineering, and so on. For example, they already construct a model for a green city, and they put in it a tiny details for how a green city could be. For example, in the humanities, there were research in the computer lab around about the topic where they have to search about difference between cultures.
Yes.
So they make a booth for example, Brazil.
Yeah.
They worked on to get all the knowledge about El Brazil.
Yes.
The exhibition was a very successful day, and the president and the heads of the university, the head of the academic research department, they were very impressed by, yeah, this day.
Dr. Hamza, how do you evaluate or see the these programs that is set for children within the project?
It is a successful. It is a successful program, of course, and the proof that every year the numbers of the students are increasing. By the way, within these days, the registration will be opened on the site of the ASRT, Academy of Research, yes. Scientific Research and yeah. Technology, and most of the parents who listen about this program start.
They are interested.
Interested, yes, to register for their students. The program is funded from the academy.
Yes.
And parents are not don't pay any fees.
Yes, Dr. Hamza, what are the events that the children have already participated in?
The Academy of Scientific Research and Technology used to, there is an annual exhibition called Cairo Innovates,
yeah.
And we used to participate in this Cairo Innovates or festival because we participate in several fields in research and in children's university
yes.
partition.
So, Dr. Hamza, what are the difficulties that faces the project and how did the university overcome these difficulties?
As I have mentioned, that the numbers are increasing. And so we are trying, it is a challenge to manage the timetable of the TAs in our university and to put to add to their timetable the timetable of the children's university and to cope the both timetables together, and we every time we succeed.
So Dr. Hamza, how do you evaluate the role of the government in supporting such a project?
Of course, it is an initiative from the academy or from the government. They implemented it 3 years ago, and they are still funding it and encouraging us. And we, every time they want to improve, to put more activities and more ideas for and upgrade the activities of the Children's University.
So what are the planning futures for this university and the programs that is going to be done?
In our university, we added last time, as I have mentioned, the exhibition. But also we already worked in our university, we have entrepreneurship center. And we work together with the team of the Entrepreneurship Center and the team of Children's University to put a new program for the kids. And we call it Kidspreneurship. Yeah. We will give or we will introduce the students to the idea to be an entrepreneur, mm-hmm. To think what is beyond the university. They have to think that they can find their own business by themselves. But of course, they have to get a product which is not harming the environment. They have to find a product which can be benefit for the community around them. But how to transfer this product to a business opportunity, they have to deal with some steps. Like they have to make market assessment, they have to make a business plan, and can transfer this useful product to a small startup.
Yeah.
And we will make it in a model, a small model internally in the university.
Yeah. So this project is building the character of the children.
Yes.
So how many generations now passed this project?
This is the third year.
It started 2015, told me.
Yes.
So only 3 years ago.
3 years, and we already, there is a group already graduated last semester. The feedback from the parents, it is 10 days only.
Yeah.
They told us that these 10 days affects very significant in the character of their children, and they feel that they get something new, different than the school.
Yes. So what are the future plans for the University of Children?
The future plans, the academy is planning to for the graduate students, that they will not let them stay by the certificate of Children's University. They will engage them in scientific research. They will engage them in some trainings, maybe, but I'm not sure, traveling outside, or kind of scholarships. We will concentrate, or will the track of ICT.
Yes.
The online learning and the online research, it will be a separate track, and it will be obligatory for the whole universities to deal with the students in the Children's University.
Well, Dr. Gihan Hamza, thank you very much for joining us. Dr. Gihan Hamza, the project manager of Children's University at Heliopolis University, thank you for your time. Thank you very much. Well, with this, my dear viewers, we come to the end of this episode of our program, Cairo Local Time, during which we've brought you the latest political, economic, social events that are taking place in Egypt. I'm Amal Mukhtar. Thank you for watching.